Learn about things like fast restore, geo-redundancy, and on-demand backups, and how they work easily in Azure Database for MySQL Flexible Server. This week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Aditi, a product manager working on MySQL Flexible Server. Thanks so much for joining us today. Can you tell us a little bit about what you do?
Sure. My name is Aditi Gupta, and I'm a product manager for Azure Database for MySQL. I've been at Microsoft for over 3.5 years. And while working in the open source landscape, I've led verticals for backup and restore, storage, and migrations.
Awesome. Cool. It seems like you're the right person to have on the show to tell us about backing up and restoring your databases on Azure Database for MySQL Flexible Server. So today we're going to be talking about some of the new things, some of the existing things, and you're going to be showing us a lot of things I've never seen before. So I'm really excited. I think like before we get into it, I wanted to ask you, like you had mentioned something about a fastest restore point to me, and I was just wondering, what is that?
So essentially selecting a restore point for your flexible server workload is a function of two activities, right? Seeding from the full automated backup and then the consequent transaction log replay. So essentially a user to minimize or optimize his restore times would want to select a time closer to these automated full backups. But unfortunately, these automated full backups were under a cloak of invisibility. And the users, they were on an average selecting restore points, which were running 12 hours of bin log replay and leading to really, really long restore times. So this was our need for speed moment. And we decided that, hey, we really need to get these automated full backups out of the cloak of invisibility and put them out in the limelight for the users to use. So what it did essentially was not only cut down the restore times to 1/10 of the original time, but also give the users visibility into the list of full available, full automated backups, so as to they could meet their audit or compliance needs. So that's essentially what a fastest restore point is.
Okay, wow, that seems like huge improvements. Of course, everyone wants to see the backups, and then to do it in 1/10 of the time as before is awesome. So I'd love to understand, like, how do you go about doing a fastest restore?
Absolutely. Let me take you to the Azure portal and show you how you can use this fastest restore point. So essentially, you land on the Azure portal on your Azure Database for MySQL Flexible Server, navigate to the backup and restore blade. Once you do that, you'll start seeing what essentially is, you know, Sherlock's memory palace, where we are retaining all your automated backups within the retention period. And so you can go ahead and see all the automated backups which have been taken within the retention period set for your flexible server, the completion timestamp, the time till which it will be retained. And the good news is you can now start your fastest restore right from this blade. So selecting one of these, you click on restore, and you land up on the point in time restore experience where we've pre-populated the fastest restore point you've just selected from the blade. And the only thing that you have got to do now is enter your server name and click on review plus create, and you're good to go.
Wow, okay. So not only is it a fast restore, but it's fast to kick off the restore.
Yes.
Awesome. That's pretty cool. And I love how simple it is to kind of use it and operate it. Just kind of makes sense. Okay, so one thing that comes up when we talk about backups, we talk about restoring, a lot of times is disaster recovery. Are there customers, and if there are, can you kind of shed some light on how customers might use some sort of geo-redundancy to help protect them in disaster recovery?
Absolutely. So in our bid to provide higher data resiliency, in addition to the existing locally redundant and zone redundant backup storage, we've now provided the users the ability to select geo-redundancy for their flexible server workloads. So what it essentially does is it takes a backup and stores in the geo-paired region of your primary region where your original flexible server is deployed. So you can now, in case of a region down or a geographic disaster, you can actually recover your flexible server by geo-restoring it to the geo-paired region by using the server's latest backup. And we give you a recovery point objective of an hour. So now let me just take you quickly to the Azure portal and show you how you can actually configure geo-redundancy and how you can trigger geo-restores to dial up your disaster recovery plans. So in addition to sort of enabling geo-redundancy right when you are creating a server, you can also come to your locally redundant server, navigate to the compute plus storage plate and to the backup section and sort of just click on the geo-redundancy checkbox and save your settings. Once you've done this, you can come to the overview blade, click on the restore option. And in addition to the point in time restore options, you now see the geo-redundant restore option has been enabled for your server, and it's going to and when selected, it's going to restore your server to the paired region. In this case, this is West US because my original server is in East US. And again, the only thing that you need to sort of go ahead and enter is the server name and hit on review plus create.
Wow, okay, that's pretty cool. Also, again, pretty easy to set up, and now you're kind of geo-redundant and are protected against a whole region going down. A lot of times something we see customers do is they do these disaster recovery kind of drills where they practice this. How could you simulate this with this scenario?
So Anna, just as a soccer team would never head into their matches without practicing, we can't expect an enterprise's first line of responders to handle a critical failure in times of an emergency situation without going through a simulation. And it's essentially important to run disaster recovery drills to ensure that the first line of responders know what to do when they are stuck with a region failure scenario. So we've made this all easy for you. And on the Azure Database for MySQL Flexible Server page, you can essentially go and stop your server, which is going to mimic the scenario when a region is down and your server is not working. And we've now enabled you to trigger geo-restores right from the portal or even through the command line interface for a stopped server. So this will not only help you benchmark your geo-restore times in case a region is down, but also give you a plan of action as to what to do on D-Day.
Got it. And I love the analogy. So thanks for sharing that. And it's a great way to kind of simulate that experience. All right. So one more question. I know we've covered a lot today. I wanted to understand a little bit more about this thing I've heard a little bit about called on-demand backups. Can you tell me more about what that is?
So on-demand backups is an exciting feature, and we are essentially putting the ball back in the user's court. And let me quickly take you to the Azure portal experience for it and what it looks like. So we are essentially empowering the users to define their own backup times and perform consequent restores. So you land on your flexible server and you navigate to the backup and restore page, and you'll start seeing the backup now option. Clicking on it is going to open the trigger on-demand backup for your server experience. Now, as Uncle Ben said to Spider-Man, with great power comes great responsibility, the sticker on the right sort of reminds the user of their responsibility of judicious use of these on-demand backups, because we are essentially giving you a limit of 50 on-demand backups or user-initiated backups per server. And the experience, we sort of auto-populate the backup name. The retention period for this backup is guardrailed by what you've set at the Uber level for your flexible server. And essentially what you've got to do here is just come here, see that you have enough left, and just click on the trigger button. Once the backup is successfully taken, you'll start seeing it listed in our ShareLocks memory palace. And again, you can sort of go ahead and perform a quick restore action from these on-demand backups. So this is giving user all the power to sort of go ahead and define their own backup times and perform restores.
Awesome, I love it. And yet again, you have these great stories and analogies to bring in, so that just makes it a lot better to understand. Aditi, thanks so much for coming on the show. Like, I learned personally so much about restores, backup, geo-redundancy, and how easy it is to kind of set this up, simulate it, practice it, and kind of be more in control and have more visibility than before. So I just want to thank you so much for coming on the show. To our viewers, go ahead and like this video if you liked it. Leave us a comment and let us know what you think about some of these existing and new capabilities. And check the description. We'll put some links for you to learn more. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed. Thank you.